Today we will begin with lesson number 3, landforms of the world, mountains and plateaus. We'll begin with mountains. Let us learn how the mountains were formed. Mountains are formed by the constant upward thrust of internal forces and due to the erosion. Erosion means the gradual destruction or wearing away of something. So, these mountains were formed by the internal forces and due to the erosion caused by external forces such as running water, ice and wind. They are so huge that they also serve as the natural frontiers between two countries. Frontier means a line or border between two countries, which separates two countries. For example, the Himalayas are a natural barrier between India and its neighbors like China, Nepal and Bhutan. Now, what is a peak? A peak is a term used to refer to the tip of the mountain. So, the tip of the mountain is known as the peak. India's highest peak is Mount Kanchenjunga, which stands at 8,586 meters on the border of India and Nepal. Mount Everest, which lies entirely in our neighboring country called Nepal. It is the tallest mountain above the sea level at the height of 8,850 meters. Mount Mauna Kea is in Hawaii, which has its base under the Pacific Ocean. Children, these mountains are based on underwater. Is the highest in the world. It measured over 10,000 meters when measured from the base to its peak. These mountains are formed in different way. Let us learn one by one. So, the very first is fold mountains. When massive slabs of solid rocks called tectonic plates are pushed up, they fold and rise up, forming fold mountains. To make your own fold mountains, with the help of some hand towels, lay 10 towels on flat surface and place 2 shoe boxes on each side like shown here. Push these shoe boxes towards the center as shown. This activity shows us how fold mountains are formed when the forces moves towards the common center. The Aravalli Mountains ranges in India is an example of old fold mountains. It was formed over 250 million years ago and has gentle slope and low altitudes due to weathering over time. The young fold mountains were formed comparatively recently, about 25 million years ago. This mountain ranges are rugged and lofty. They comprise the world's highest mountain ranges like Alps of Europe and Himalayas of Asia. Other examples of these mountains are Rocky Mountains in North America and the Andes in South America. So the next is block mountains. Block mountains are formed when cracks or faults occur in the earth's crust and the land between the cracks sinks, leaving upside blocks on either sides. Block mountains are known as fault block mountains. We can make our own fault mountain using a long eraser. Take a long eraser and use a pencil to draw fault lines on it. Use a cutter or blade to cut eraser across the lines earlier. Place the piece of long eraser together to make the eraser hole again. Apply
a little pressure on the corner pieces and lift the whole eraser above the table. Slowly pull the corners pieces apart and you can see how the land in the middle of fault lines subsides and block mountains are formed on either side. The uplifted blocks are called the host and the lowest one are called the graben. As you can see on the screen, edges of the mountains are steep and the surface are almost leveled. Example of block mountain is Vosges in Europe, Black Forest in Germany and Sierra Nevada in North America. The marble rocks at Jabalpur are also an example of block mountains which are found in India. Next is volcanic mountain. Due to extreme heat inside the earth, rocks turn into molten magma or lava. This sometimes makes its way to the surface of earth and comes out through an opening or a vent. The opening through which the lava and other materials come to the earth's surface is called a vent. This lava cools down and becomes solid. This happens repeatedly. The lava layers build up and this forms a cone-shaped volcanic mountain. These kind of mountains are found in Hawaii, Myanmar, Italy and Japan. This region is around the Pacific Ocean. And it's shaped like a horseshoe. That's why it is popularly known as Pacific Ring of Fire. It covers countries such as Indonesia, Philippines, Japan, and many islands in Pacific Ocean, and countries on the west coast of North and South America.